Back here at home, police in California are learning more about the 22-year-old man who went on a killing rampage this weekend. But the case also shows once again how difficult it is for police to decide if someone with mental health problems is a danger to the community. Heather Sells has the story.
Elliot Roger left behind a great deal of information about why he went on his shooting rampage Friday, but it's still hard for this community to understand.
I don't really have words to say like how kind of shocking it is just to know what happened.
Authorities are now reviewing his writings in which he detailed his killing plan, as well as this chilling YouTube video.
Tomorrow is the day of retribution. The day in which I will have my revenge against humanity.
Roger describes years of loneliness and rejection by women and other friends. Some say they tried to help him.
He was really, really upset about why is the world so unfair to him.
I mean, I can only do so much. Like, I tried reaching out to him every chance I got, but he was, like, so closed off, there's nothing I could do.
Authorities say Roger's rampage started in his apartment where he stabbed three men. He then drove around on and near the UC Santa Barbara campus and fired shots at young women at this sorority house and at people at this deli mart. Sierra Swartz says she was 10 feet from his car when he fired at her multiple times.
He looked directly at me, and somehow, even though I hadn't even ran yet, he didn't hit me.
In the end, Roger shot and killed himself inside the black BMW he used to carry out the violence. Last month, his parents contacted police after being alarmed by videos about suicide and killing. But after talking with Roger, police determined there was no threat. Health experts say the case highlights the challenges that police face in assessing mental health, especially for those with no history of violent breakdowns or serious crimes. UC Santa Barbara students held a vigil on Saturday, and the community is planning an interfaith vigil for Tuesday. Heather Sells, CBN News.